When you look at number two, the first thing that might occur to you is, wow, I've seen this before. We solved this problem where I pulled with 100 newtons on a string around this same wheel. Right? This is different because you're not pulling with 100 newtons. You have a mass with a gravitational force of 100 newtons on it. Okay, so what's the difference? Let's look at dynamics and energetics. From dynamics, the tension is not 100 newtons anymore because this is accelerating. And so the force left over for the tension is the force of gravity minus the force used up to accelerate this. If it's accelerating down, then the tension is going to be less than the force of gravity. So the acceleration of this is going to be somewhat less than the acceleration in the other problem. From an energetics perspective, we recognize that the loss of potential energy is equal to the kinetic energy of the system. But now that same 200 joules, 100 newtons times 2 meters, is not just going into this wheel, but it's being shared by the wheel and by this mass. So we add that extra term in when we conserve energy. And so how do we deal with these two different variables? We recognize that omega is equal to V over R, or V is equal to omega R. So take your pick. I chose to solve for omega, and I wound up with an omega of about 41 per second by the time this reaches the bottom. Because this is 10 centimeters, we know the final speed is about 4 meters per second. The average speed is 2 meters per second, so therefore it takes about a second to get to the bottom. And then we can find this acceleration is about 4.2 meters per second squared, or alpha is about 42 per second squared.